Hi everyone, welcome back to Rust. I got raided overnight. They didn't kill me though, funnily enough. They came, raided everything, stole it all from me, and then they left me here. They stole everything from my chests. But what I did, I was actually recording this, but I was using my mechanical keyboard by accident instead of my nice quiet one, which is what I usually use to record. And yeah, that footage isn't very good. So I'm gonna skip all of that. I kind of wish I'd used this keyboard, but it's done now. And plus, it most of what I was doing was just mining away some rock and stuff. Some guy gave us some tools, which was really nice of him, and he gave me the shirt that I'm wearing as well. So yeah, he was a nice guy. He helped us out a bit. But look, this is what happened. Someone basically laddered up to my base, and they broke in while I was asleep and stole everything. Which is okay, because now what we can do is break their puny defenses. Oh my god, look at that. Chain reaction, bitch. Nice. Okay. So, what my plan is really is I want to just get myself set up a little bit again, because I lost everything before. And so I'm trying to get myself all set up. Why is my mouse? Sorry. My mouse is just like the wire keeps getting caught on something. I'm just fixing it right now. Okay. It's fixed. Is it fixed? It seems to be fixed. Hopefully it doesn't unfix itself. Okay, let's parkour back up here. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm just gonna store all my stuff back into the chest. Now that I've repaired the damage that was done, we also just want to check how quickly I can break through my door, the one that I locked myself, this door here. I want to see how the bow and arrow fares against it. And if it fares terribly, what we'll do is we'll try and. Oh shit, someone's obviously stole my revolver. I thought I was going to say something. Okay. Does it take. Ah, okay. So we actually have to shoot it 200 times to break through it with this. That is not going to happen. I don't have the patience for that. So, what we are going to do is store everything in here. All of this cool stuff. In here you go. Yep. Everything. Except for my tools. I'm going to keep those on me. And maybe my shirt. I'll keep my shirt on so that people recognize me and say, hey, this is a civilized person. You know, he's wearing a shirt. Should I cook up some stuff while I'm waiting, or while I'm gone? Let's start cooking up this high quality metal because we need that, right? To make ourselves a gun again, like the rifle. We need some high quality metal. So I'm gonna leave that in there to cook while I go out and try and get some blueprints. More blueprint fragments, the better, right? And maybe get some more higher quality tools, and maybe even find some more guns. We are close to the satellite, and also we are right next to Sips's base. I didn't even realize this when I started building over here, but I actually have set up really close to Sips's house and Thrill House, and like a big community is formed around them. You know, it's great. But like when I checked out before, it looks like they are completely like at war with someone. I don't think they're actually online, but there's a lot of people moving into the area with guns, so it's not really the best. So we're just sort of casually staying out of this war for now. We have got our own little base over there, obviously, that any refugees from the war can come over to me. Is Lewis on? No, I don't think Lewis is on. Although it would be kind of cool if he was. Okay. Was there a raw chicken breast inside that barrel? That's kind of worrying that someone sealed up a raw chicken breast inside of a 200-year-old barrel out in the middle of nowhere. You have to wonder what was going through their mind. Let's eat an apple. Yum. So we're just gonna carry on trying to loot around. Hopefully no one's too bothered with this area at the moment, because everyone's got to be bothered with destroying Sips and Thrill House and those guys. I wonder what we should call that community, because I don't actually know if it has a name. Let's call it... Let's call it... I mean, I don't know if you can see it from here. That's it over there. Like, you see the dome over there, right? In front of the dome, like in perspective, you can see all those buildings. That's actually where all of that's going on. Sips' base is like behind those trees. So we could give it a name, right? Maybe we could call it like... Hey, there's a guy there. Maybe we could call it Dish Town. Because it's like near the satellite dishes. Or Dish City. That's my name for it anyway, Dish City. It's near the satellite dishes. Lots of canned beans to be eaten around Dish City. And also lots of people that could kill you, because I'm not really paying much attention to those sort of guys, but they could kill me at any time. This area, I found out, is actually what's called an RDM, like an RDM zone. It is fully within the rules to just shoot people on site here without any, you know, warning or anything. You could just shoot them and take everything. Though I think it is actually against the rules, or at least it's frowned upon to do that out, like, outside. You're sort of encouraged to RP a bit and talk to the person before trying to kill them. Which, you know, is fair enough. We will do that at some point. But at the moment, since I'm still setting up everything, you know, I'm still a bit of a noob. I lost all of my stuff. I can't afford to be a bandit right now. I have to go through the struggle of, you know, trying to beg people not to kill me. But the tables will turn, mark my words. Within a few days, I will be the new greatest danger on the server. What is that? The new greatest danger on the server? Hey. What's up, Gaming Benjamin? Your head is actually clipping through your hat.
How's it going?
Yeah, it's going good.
Is it?
Yeah, your forehead and like the side of your head is clipping through your hat. Hey, nice armor.
Yeah, man, thanks.
Yeah, I'm just out here looking for some barrels and stuff. It looks like there's a lot of gunfire around here earlier, so I'm trying to avoid the area a little bit.
That was the orcs and me taking back my friend's house. You know Ballara?
I don't. I haven't been on the server for like 24 hours, so I've missed a lot.
Well, P-Flax and Barry were just breaking into a house, so we took it back.
Oh, well, are they over in that area at the moment? I could come and help you out.
I think they've backed away now, but the orcs have gone back to their base and Laura's fixing up her house.
Whereabouts are the orcs actually based? I've heard all this talk about them, but I don't know where they are.
Orcs are literally just that way. If you go that way, be careful though, because I don't know if they'll shoot at you or anything, but they have a base set up literally just over that hill.
Okay, so it looks like all the action is actually... All of the action is in this area, right? I accidentally set up right near this area, so I'm going to get caught in the middle.
Seems like it.
Yeah. Oh, okay. That's a shame.
It'll be fine. P-Flax doesn't usually come out this far. I don't know why he was here.
Oh, man. Well, I mean, I did see Sips...
Set up on the hill, I think.
Sips was saying about how they're going to lead a big war band to destroy P-Flax. So, I'm probably going
to... I'd be happy to join that.
Yeah, I'd be happy to join it as well, but I'm probably going to die. I mean, my luck isn't really the best. I can hear someone.
Man.
Oh, hi.
Sacrifices have to be made.
Hello.
Hey.
Nice armor.
It's you again. What's going on?
Yeah.
Thanks, man.
You're with the orcs, right?
Yeah, of course.
Alright, sweet. Thank you for your help earlier.
Oh, that's okay. That's what we do.
Man, what a bunch of nice guys.
Wilsonator tells me there's talk that Sips might be leading a force against P-Flax. Guys,
oh, I didn't say that.
Obviously we're interested.
This shouldn't be common knowledge.
What did you say, Wilsonator?
I'm so sorry. I may or may not have got some outside information on this, but don't tell anyone that I told you.
Okay.
Right.
I didn't know what you're talking about. I haven't heard anything.
Thank you very much. Thank you. That's exactly what I want to hear. Anyway, I'm going to go back to hunting blueprints.
Is that all right?
Yeah, if you want. Sure.
It's been right, nice sweet. Talking to you guys.
Yeah, I'm going to add you as well.
Barrel. All
right.
Peace, boys.
Wilsonator, I'm going to add you to the map.
Okay, cool. Right. What map? I don't know anything about a map. See, these are some nice guys, right? They're sort of sharing some information about the current state of politics. Right, alright, thanks. Anyway, best of luck. Try not to die out here, and I'll try also not to die out here. Yeah.
Alright, sweet.
See ya, man.
Good luck to you, man.
What a nice guy.
See ya.
Oh, let's go skipping back through the daisies back towards the satellite dish. So, from this bit of intelligence that I've learned, it seems like P-Flax, Pyrian Flax, is actually based, like, out there. Probably in that tower. I mean, that tower looks kind of ominous, right? I've been told that he's to be avoided at all costs. And I didn't realize how close I was to the main action of the server, which seems to be all based around this area. I mean, you heard that gunshot, right? That's probably P-Flax shooting at me right now. Oh my god. And I may not have spilled the beans about Sips's plan to attack the guys. So is P-Flax with the orcs, or are the orcs against him? Because that guy said he was one of the orcs. I don't know much about, I don't know what's going on with like the other guys. I've just been sort of minding my own business here on the server, so I'm a bit sort of behind on the state of politics and affairs. I don't really know the factions and, you know, who runs what. Who the fuck lives up there? Is that P-Flax? It might be. We're not going to go and find out. Because I can see someone, I think. No, maybe that's just like a rock. But yeah, I'm not really in any sort of position at the moment. Man, it's kind of lucky then that I... No. Not lag. It's kind of lucky that I didn't set up on that hill. Because remember, like, there's like, I can still see it. That was like the little base I started making up there. And I was going to sort of set up my base up there, but it looks like there's a lot of people up there now. And there's also a guy standing down there. Oh, he's right here. Hi. Hey.
Hello.
Are you lagging or is it just me?
I think it's just you, pal.
Okay, thanks. Alright, well, it's just me this time. It seems like it's not the server lagging this time like what happened before. Which is a shame. Hopefully that guy doesn't kill me, because he looked like he was ready to put that pickaxe through my skull. Which hopefully he doesn't do. There's also someone else running up on me. Hey, I'll give it to you. I'll give it to you.
Taking precaution.
Hey, look, there you go.
Give me what?
Take them all.
Give me what?
That's all I've got, man.
Thank you.
I've got nothing else.
I'm not gonna kill you, don't worry, man. I'm a friendly guy, right?
Okay.
I can't believe you thought I'm gonna kill you. That's just.
Well, everyone else kills me.
Okay, I'll kill you.
Thanks.
Well, not me. I will not kill you.
Okay, you.
My name. Wait, let me get closer. You can remember my name.
The Laughing Gamer.
Oh my god, are you?
Yeah.
Is this the real Wilsonator?
Yeah, it's the real Wilsonator.
Right? No, it's not.
What?
Yeah,
I'm actually recording a video at the moment, so I mean, if you want to kill me, you can do it.
Gonna be in the video.
Yeah, you're gonna be in the video.
Oh, sick. Okay, then, cool. What's your YouTube?
Just Wilsonator YT. It's got a nice little YT on the end.
All right, cool. I'll check it out then. I've got you a sub.
All right, thanks, man, and thanks for not killing me as well. Everyone else does.
Goodbye, Wilsonator.
Goodbye, man.
Nah, I don't kill people. Right,
see you later. Wow. I think he was actually going to kill me until he found out who I was. Because he wanted to see my name first. So if I had been anyone else, that would have been me dead. But it's kind of nice to have people sparing my life just because they sort of know who I am. But at the same time, I think this is a bit of a wake-up call, right? I just gave him all of my blueprint fragments. Which, you know, I kind of needed them. That was my only blueprint fragments that I had. But, you know, what's done is done. I'm not going to go and ask for them back. I'm just going to sort of pretend that he robbed me, of them. But it's also a wake-up call. It's probably time to get out of this area for a little bit, because it looks like there's a lot of people around here now. It was quiet before, but it looks like there's loads of people coming in here to... he's talking in the chat. Madness. Just met Wilsonator. Mad. Oh, man. Okay. Just gonna get some more rock, and then we'll head back to our little hut and see what goes on out there. I've got this snaptrap already. You know, I'll take it back anyway. Or should I put it in this little chest? What's this? Free. Okay, this is a box for free stuff, so I'll put it in there for someone. Where did I get this low-grade fuel? I think I picked it up from one of the boxes or something. Possibly. Alright, well, what we'll do, we'll head back to our little hut, and we'll see about getting some, you know what, no we won't. I want to get some more high-quality metal so we can smelt it and build a rifle, so that I can defend myself, and possibly attack other people. I mean, I'm a nice guy, but I'm also kind of, like, I'm nice, but I'm not, if that makes sense. I'm usually nice, but I have this urge to kill everyone I see at all times. Though I think that's just like my a spirit possessing me and taking over my mind. But sometimes I want to let them, you know, have a bit of free reign over what I do. Let me shoot people in the head and take all that stuff. That'd be fun. Just to do like things like that. We are leaderless after P-Flax left. So is that the orcs? I guess it is. So I guess P-Flax is with the orcs. Sorry, I'm just reading the chat. I'm like on and off reading it. Hey, is there an airplane coming? I see like the little green thing on the bar at the bottom. He left the orcs and we had a moment of bloodlust. Okay, so maybe he was the leader of the orcs and then he left. Oh man, look, I can actually see inside the little house. Oh look, there's a plane. It's nowhere near me, so it's okay. All right. So, I did actually go and investigate, like, Sips Village, but there's someone shooting at me. Wait, is he shooting at me? Oh, no, he's not. There's someone over there who's shooting at somebody, though. So, probably best to probably get inside and try and hide from whoever that could be. Come on. This hardcore parkour needs to be put to good work right now. Come on. There we go. All right. As you can see, the guy... Did I hear a voice? Okay, yeah, as you can see, I wasn't joking when I said that I was the greatest parkour champion in Europe. Because it's the truth. Alright. We don't quite have enough high-quality metal right now, but we've got a decent amount. We need, like, 30 to make a rifle, right? That's how much we need. We do have quite a bit of stone and everything, though. We've got a decent amount. But when we make our high-powered rifle, or whatever it's called, we'll use it to break down the door, and then we can try and build, like, an armored one with a code. Because this is really vulnerable. Like, the way that I've been getting in and out is through a hole in my floor. And, I mean, that is really stupidly vulnerable. Okay. So, let's put our other valuable stuff in here. We'll probably stay in here for the night so that we don't get killed in the darkness. We've got some raw chicken. And I actually do have some more blueprints. I thought I lost them all to that guy. I can't remember his name. Like, Laughing Gamer or something? I was a bit worried, actually, when he came up to me. But he turned out to be better than I thought he would be. Okay, I'm actually going to go down. While those are all smelting, just to spice it up a bit, I'm going to try and get some more rock. Some more high quality metal. We need 30, so we need 10 more, I think. About 10 more, anyway. So let's start. Alright, we've got 3. Really? 3? From one hit? Nice. I'm just like looking at my outputs I'm getting on the side there. Let's see if we get some more. Loads of metal ore. Loads of stones. Don't think we've got any more high quality metal yet. I'm just a bit worried that I'm gonna get snuck up on by like some sort of blood sucking dog, even. You know, the Chupacabra. I only know what the Chupacabra is from watching The Walking Dead. And they talked about like this dog that lives out in the forests in rural America. And he basically lives in the bushes. And he sits there with red eyes and comes out of the bushes like, row! And then he bites into you and sucks your blood. Heiku Hovel. Never thought I'd see a Heiku Hovel in my life. Oh, look, there it is. It's the Chupacabra. Let's chase it! Come back here, Chupacabra! You son of a bitch. The Chupacabra also has some sort of high-class parkour training by the looks of things. I can't see anything. I can't see where the Chupacabra went either. It may have actually been a deer, not a Chupacabra. And actually, I think it probably was. To be honest though, the wolves probably are more like Chupacabras because they actually do attack you. The deer just run away. And wolves are also dogs, so they look the part. So if we're trying to roleplay that something's a Chupacabra, maybe the wolf would be the best thing to do it with. Alright, let's carry on getting some more stone. Hopefully get some... Yep, we've got some more high quality. I only got one though, so we've got four. We just need six more high quality metal. We might have to make another pickaxe to do so though, because this one's starting to break. Yeah, it's going to break quite soon actually. But the good thing about this is, even if I'm not getting like the high quality metal that easily, I am getting all the other stones and normal metal ore and sulfur ore and all that stuff. So, you know, it all pays off in the end. We make a gun. Oh, yep, got one more. We need to get like a flipping double, triple, quadruple whammy on the high quality metal. That'd be really nice. Okay. I just wanted to apologize quickly here. I think I've been talking really fast like in this episode. So if I have been, I really am sorry if I'm talking too fast for anyone to comprehend. But I'm just excited, you know. I'm terrified. I'm no longer excited after that gunshot rang out into the cool night air. You know, it's a nice clear night. It would be not really a nice night to die on. In fact, it would be. But I don't want to die. So it's kind of part and part. Like, it's a nice night to die, but I don't really want to die. Because it's like, you imagine someone holds you at gunpoint, like they've got a gun to the back of your head and they're like, it's a nice night to die. And you could either say, yeah, it sure is, which would be the truth. Or you could lie and say, no, it's not. Fuck, I have no idea what I'm even going on about right now, but that moon went down really fast. I mean, it was really bright there for a second, and then it just vanished across the horizon. Have I not even died, like, since I've been on? I don't think I have. I think everyone who could have killed me has actually spared my life so far. I don't want to jinx it, because then I'll say that and I'll just get shot in the back of the head. That would be a shame. Okay, what we could do... This is a bit interesting, right? What we could do is sort of use our status, like, my status, not ours. Like, I always say, like, we or our. But I'm just talking about me. So I could use my status as someone that everyone says, oh, hey, I could use that to my advantage, right? So I sneak up on people and I say, hey, it's me, Wilsonator. And then I pull out a bolt-action rifle and I shoot them in the face when they're, like, saying hi. But I feel like kind of a dick if I do that. But, I mean, it could work, right? That would be a great way to be a bandit. I just walk up to people and say hi, and then I shoot them in the face. I'm just hypothesizing. I'm making a hypothetical theory here on how to assassinate people. It's not to be taken literally. I'm not going to do it, but I might at some point decide to do it. We'll just have to see. This is talking far in the future. Alright, well, we'll head over to Dish City in a little minute. And we'll see if we can... Actually, no, we won't. We're going to head back to base because we've nearly got enough high quality metal to make the gun. So we also probably need to make some more bullets. So how do you make those again? 10 metal fragments and 5 gunpowder. Okay, so those are kind of easy to make. We just need to smelt everything back up again. We only need like one more high quality metal to be able to make the gun, which was nice. Come on. Give it to me. Wait, what? Okay, well, the rock I was just breaking just vanished in thin air. Which is fine. I don't have any problems with rocks vanishing in thin air, but it would be nice if it warned me first. Aha! Nice, let's head back. I've got 12 high quality metal. Got a nice amount of stone. We should have enough stone for a little while. And could do with more wood. In fact, let's do it. Let's chop down some trees on the way back as well. And then we'll just throw all of this stuff into the furnace. And we'll make our bolt action rifle. It'll be great. Wow. Did a tree just grow in the place that one was? Like, I think I broke one and then another one grew in its place. That would be kind of hilarious if that's actually what happened. But I'm not actually sure if that is what happened. Okay. Let's head back over the hills and far away. Is that like from the Teletubbies or something? I mean, I don't watch the Teletubbies, but I used to when I was like a little kid. I used to love the Teletubbies. Like they were all like multiple colors, right? And they had TVs on their tummies. Did you guys get that in America? Or was that just a British show, Teletubbies? Because I know quite a lot of you guys are American, so let me know. If you didn't get the Teletubbies, I suggest you go and watch it. It's kind of amazing and quite kind of creepy at the same time. Okay. Oh my god. I only say that I think that... Oh my god. I only say that I think it, like, I'm not sure if it's American, because I'm sure that they were like, it was like on one of those like really British kids channels. Like, cause they had a few of them over here where they were like over the top British. Which, I mean, fair enough, but I don't know. Generally, a lot of these British things aren't that popular outside of Britain. Okay, well, here's the high quality metal. I just realized I'm probably wasting all this fuel because I've just been letting it burn. Oh, crap. Do we not even... Oh, no, we need, like, one more. I thought I had 10. I thought I had 10 high quality metal here. We need more. Okay, we need, like, one more piece. Let's go get that. No, not now. No, I wanted to put my stuff in here first. Okay, let's do that then. Let's store all of our new stuff. In fact, we also might want to put half of the wood in here. Half of the wood in here. And we're going to smelt up some metal fragments and also some sulfur to make these bullets that I need to have. The server is actually lagging a little bit, or I'm lagging a little bit. That guy said it was me, so. And, I mean, he seemed like quite a trustworthy guy. Let's put the rest of this shit into here. Can I take my bow out with me? You know what? I'm going to take my bow out with me this time. Just in case we run into someone that we want to shoot, we can do it. Maybe get some sweet headshots. You know, 360 degree quick scopes with the bow and arrow. That would be really nice. See, here's the thing with the bow, right? It works really nice in this game. There's a lot of games that... Okay, so basically, the bow and arrow weapon is either really good in a game or it's really bad in a game. It's never sort of okay. It's either really good or really bad. You know, you never get like okay bow physics in a game for some reason. Just, I mean, not really that, like, nice. Oh my god. See, this is, when I'm breaking down trees, I don't even know what I'm going on about half the time. So, I do apologize if I'm just talking shit. But, that's what wood chopping does to you, you know? It sort of makes your brain start melting in your ears. And, you know, leaking out. And you have to, while chopping the tree, carve off slices of the tree, like, paper thin. And use those pieces of paper to scrape out the bits of your brain that's leaking out the side of your ear. And then You can make a candle or something out of your own brain wax. Something like that. Okay, let's get some more high quality. Ah, got it. You know what, I'm just going to break through the whole rock here, just in case we are actually still short on high quality metal. Because my math skills suck. I haven't done any math since I finished school. And the extent of my math knowledge is pretty much 1 plus 1 equals 4. Yep. I'm only joking, by the way. I know it's 2. Don't think I'm that dumb. I'm kind of dumb, but not that dumb. Alright, let's see if we can shoot a chupacabra on the way back. If there is any to shoot. There doesn't seem to be any around. Does someone live in this house? If so, his window's open. Woohoo! Anyone home? I don't think there's anyone home. And if there is, actually, let's do some sort of spy move. Can we go down the chimney? Oh my god, I think we can. Watch this. Oh man, my parkour skills may not be adequate. Oh, will they? Hang on. Let's see, I have to check. This guy put a chimney on here for a reason. Aha! Should I go down the chimney? I might have to. I can hear gunshots over there. There is a ladder. Okay, I'm going to do it. I might not be able to get out of here, but... No, I'm not going down there. There's a locked door right there. Whew! That was close. I would have fallen down there. I would have had to kill myself to get back out. That was really close. I was literally on the verge. I pressed the button like to start walking off the edge, and I quickly pressed the other one to counter that movement as soon as I saw what there was to see. Let's hope nobody's sneaking into my base, because I heard a gunshot come from the direction of my base. Is this my base? It is. Yeah, because there's a giant hole in the floor. I didn't know someone was so close to me. Let's hope that whoever is shooting out here isn't trying to kill me. Okay, I can hear my furnace is still going up there. Just having a great time. We've got more wood, so we can use that as well. As I figure out the way up to my base. Oh my god, there we go. Man, I can't wait till this gun's finished so I can just blow that door down. I mean, I'm assuming the gun does a lot of damage to doors. I've never tested it. I fell off again. Fuck. I know that... Man. Come on. Please. Let me up. Okay. Hardcore parkour. Oh my god, look at that. See that? It only took one jump. And two little baby jumps. Ah! Man. I need a rope or something. Can I just like toss a rope down and pull myself up with that? That'd be nice. I think people are streaming again. I'd like to do a stream one day. If you guys want me to do a stream at some point, let me know and I'll see what I can do. I've never done a stream before, and I'm a bit scared. I'm very scared. And also, another thing I wanted to just say to, like, while you guys are all watching this is, if you want me to play any games, like other games other than Rust, because I enjoy this game a lot, but, you know, there's a lot of games out there that I could play as well and do, like, separate series on the side. Let me know, and you know, I'm happy to take a look at many games. But yeah, just bear that in mind. I'm always sort of open to suggestions for what to play. All right, let's see. Is our gun ready to be made? Why can't I open this? My game is lagging. All right, let's put this high quality metal. We've got enough high quality metal. Let's see if we can make the bow action rifle. I need more cloth. I've got enough. Okay, I can make it. Whew! Let's try not to lose this one. And how do we make these? We make 10 metal fragments, 5 gunpowder. And you make gunpowder with charcoal and sulfur. Yep, we can do this. This should be okay. We should be able to make a few bullets, at least. There's enough charcoal for the whole family. Gunpowder. Make 30 gunpowder. And then we can make the bullets. We can make a total of 9 bullets at the moment, I think. Alright. Let's see about knocking this door down. Does it really not do that much damage? Oh man. Looks like this will have to be something I'll probably end up doing off camera at some point. Just to, you know, just to save the tedium, because that's going to be a really tedious moment. Alright, we've got our gun back. I'm going to head back out to the barrel area, if I don't fall off of here. Because I need to go and get some more, like, chocolate bars and apples and granola bars. Hey! Hey! Are you one of the guys I met earlier? Oh, that's it. What's up?